Hi, boys and girls. Pastor Joey here with my good friend, Pastor Risa. You'll see her soon enough when you get into the 7th and 8th grade. But we're here with another exciting lesson on taking on those giants. And Pastor Risa is going to help us with today's Good to Know.
Hey, boys and girls, if you do not know what a Good to Know is, it's the one thing you need to remember out of all the things that Pastor Joey's going to say. And today's Good to Know is that I'm not too young to take on a giant.
Whoa, what giants are we talking about here, Pastor Risa?
All sorts of giants, like LeBron and Kobe and Shaq.
Those are giants, but we're really talking about those giants that kind of bog us down from our walk with Jesus Christ. You know, the lying, those bad habits of maybe cheating or stealing or anger, you know, all of those things. So remind the boys and girls one more time what today's Good to Know is.
Today's Good to Know is I'm not too young to take on the giants.
Whoa, am I too young to take them on?
You're definitely too young to take them on.
Are you too young to take them on?
I'm not too young to take them on.
No, the old guy is Steve. He can't take them on. He's too old. Hey, take a look what's coming up. Boys and girls, Pastor Joey here. Today we're learning about a young hero of the Bible named David. Now, David recognized that somebody needed to take on the giant Goliath, so it might as well be him. David was young, but he didn't let that stop him from volunteering to fight the giant Goliath. Now, David certainly could have come up with some excuses of why he was too young. Now, David could have said, "I just want to have fun, man." Or he could have said, "I've got too many things to do. I have my friends, I have sports, I have activities, I have to watch my father's sheep." There are many excuses he could have thrown out, but instead he understood this one thing. You're never too young to take on your own giants. David understood that he couldn't sit around and wait for the other soldiers to take on this giant. They were all too scared. David was going to have to face this giant himself, with God's help, of course. David didn't make excuses for how young he was. In today's world, you know, most kids have giant problems, giant habits, giant issues that you guys face. Sadly, many kids assume that they are just too young to take on that giant. They think, maybe when I'm older, I'll try to defeat this giant. I'm just too young. Boys and girls, that's just not true. God can work through anyone, no matter how young you may be. Do you remember what I said last week? If you ignore the giant and think you can just take care of it later, it will only get worse.
Hello, friends. It is me, Anna, today, and I will continue to tell you the story of David and Goliath. Last week, we left off having met Goliath, the giant Philistine, who threatened the army of Israel. He wanted one of the Israelites to come out and face him in battle. If they beat him, then the Philistines would be the slaves of Israel forever. But if Goliath won, the Israelites would have to become the slaves of the Philistines forever. Over and over, Goliath came out and screamed to the army of Israel, "Send me a man who will fight me." Each day, the Israelite army stood, shaking in their boots. They would never send anyone out to fight Goliath. All of the soldiers were way too scared. But there was a young shepherd boy named David that lived in Israel. He had tons of brothers who were fighting in the army. David's dad, Jesse, asked him to take some food out to his brothers. He wanted to let them know that the family back home was thinking about them. This is exactly what David did. He gathered the food and made the long journey to the battle lines where his brothers had been for some time. Then, David arrived at the place where the battle was supposed to be taking place. He expected to see all kinds of fighting going on, but that's not what he saw. He saw the entire army of Israel hiding while the giant Goliath screamed and yelled insults at them. David even heard Goliath say all kinds of curses about the Almighty God. David was so shocked and surprised by this. Not only was he shocked by all the terrible things that Goliath was saying about God and God's people, but he was amazed that no one was doing anything about it. The entire army of Israel was allowing this big giant to talk like this about God and threaten his people. David, he began to ask the soldiers around him, "Is there no one who will stand up to this giant Philistine?" The soldiers told him that everyone was afraid to fight Goliath. Here they were, grown soldiers trained to fight, but no one wanted to fight Goliath. David spoke up and said, "I'll fight this giant." David was just a young shepherd boy, but he knew he was not too young to take on this huge giant. Today, we are going to learn about how we can do the same thing as David. We are never too young to take on the giant problems in our life. With God's help, we can defeat them.
You're never too young to take on your giant. David knew this, and he was willing to challenge Goliath even though he was still just a young boy. You can take on your giant. Why? Because it's not how old you are, it's how much God is in you. The reason you can take on your giant is not because of you're old enough or you're powerful enough on your own. No way! The reason you can take on your giant is because you have the power of God. It's inside of you. It's not how old you are. It's how much God is in you. That's why David was able to volunteer to take on Goliath. And that's why you can choose to take on your giant problem in life. So if you know that you can take on your giant no matter what your age, then Pastor Joey's got a question for you. When will you choose to take on your giant? David didn't wait. The very moment he saw the enemy, Goliath, he stood up and said, "I will fight this giant."
Feel the wonder, say his name. Watch the darkness slip away. Put your power on display. Say goodbye to fear and shame.
Hi, boys and girls. Welcome to today's Power Verse. You know, we've been talking about those giants in our life.
Giants!
What is going on?
Ryan, boys and girls, again, we're dealing with the giants, so we need to take care of them. Ryan, I will defend you. Gah!
Eddie, not with the plastic fish
back.
Again, all right?
Back!
Give me the fish!
That's my lunch.
Say goodbye to the fish.
Bye-bye, fish.
Bye-bye.
I love you.
I tell you, you've turned that plastic fish into some kind
That's not a plastic fish.
That's lunch. That's lunch. And I'm not a giant, okay?
Yes, look, boys and girls. Look how tall he is.
Yeah.
And ugly.
Oh, my God.
And just funny looking.
Okay, that's enough. That's enough. Now, come on. We're talking to the boys and girls today about how to deal with those giants, but specifically, they're not too young to deal with those giants.
They're not too young to deal with giants?
No.
If they're 5 years old?
If they're 5 years old.
They're 7 years old?
7 years old.
Or 52?
Whoa, watch yourself now.
What's wrong with 52?
52 is a nice young age,
yes,
although I'm not 52.
You're not 52?
No.
Well, if you're over 50, you're closer to 100 than you are a zero.
Oh my goodness, Eddie. Well, it doesn't matter what your age, you're never too young or too old to take on those giants in your life.
So what type of giants are we talking about today?
We're talking about those type of giants that just kind of creep in and create bad habits and things that aren't pleasing to God.
Bad habits? Lying. These kids don't have bad habits.
Oh, yes, we all do, Eddie, including yourself.
Okay, like what?
Oh my goodness, how about some back sass?
Back what?
Back sass.
Is that barbecue sauce?
No, that's not barbecue sauce. That's a bad habit.
Eating's a bad habit.
Eating too much is a bad habit.
You don't have a problem with that, right?
No, I do not.
No, not at all.
I eat just enough. Oh my goodness. Yeah, all those things. We've got to be careful because they'll creep in and kind of destroy our witness for God.
Okay, so is there anything in the Bible that might help us with these giants?
I'm so glad that you asked. In fact, yes, the Apostle Paul, he had a young pastor friend that he was constantly mentoring and encouraging.
Oh, what did he tell him?
He told him in the book of 1 Timothy, chapter 4, verse 12, he told Timothy, he said, listen, don't let anyone think less of you because you're young.
Don't think anyone less of you because you are young. Well, you don't have that problem because you're not young.
Oh my goodness, I am young at heart. Exactly, I'm young at heart. And that's what Paul was saying. He said, listen, Timothy, don't let anyone think less of you because you're young, but be an example to all believers.
Be a what?
An example.
How do you be an example?
Well, you be an example that when you are walking according to God's word and doing the things that you should do, people are watching.
Watching.
And they are seeing. And therefore, you're being an example.
They're saying, wow, that is an old giant.
Oh my goodness. No, it's not an old giant, but it could be a giant or it could be a young giant. But anyway, it's got to be dealt with.
Okay. So how do we deal with it?
So this is how we deal with it. We take Paul's word to Timothy and we take it to heart.
Okay.
And know that we can defeat those giants starting today.
Okay, so what is the verse that tells us to deal with these giants?
Are you ready to go over it with
me? Not really, but let's go.
Let's do it. Okay, repeat after me, then we'll get the boys and girls to repeat.
Sure.
Here we go. 1 Timothy 4:12.
1 Timothy 4:12.
Good job.
Good job.
All right. Don't let anyone think less of you.
Think less of you.
Because you're young.
Well, that works for you because you're not young. That's perfect.
One more time. Are you ready?
Okay.
Here we go. Don't let anyone think less of you.
Think less of you.
Because you're young.
Because you're young.
Be an example.
Be an example.
To all believers.
To all believers.
Good job. All right. Now let's get the boys and girls. Can you both stand up with me already? Both boys and girls. Here we go. Stand up. And repeat after me. Make it loud and clear.
Nice and loud.
That your mom and dad can hear. Are you ready? Here we go, Eddie. Don't let anyone think less of you.
Think less of you.
Because you're young.
Because you are young.
Be an example.
Be an example.
To all believers.
To all believers.
1 Timothy
4:12. 4:12.
That's good, Eddie.
That's great.
Great job, boys and girls.
Good job for an old dude. Very proud of you. Everyone, give a round of applause to the old guy.
Oh my goodness,
thank
Eddie.
You.
Yes, no matter what your age, you can set an example to everyone that's watching you that, you know what, I can take on these problems right now because I got the power of God in me.
That's excellent.
That is excellent.
We should go grab lunch.
Yes, let's
Did
go
you bring
get
anything?
Lunch. I didn't bring anything.
I brought a fish. What happened to it?
That's a rubber fish. Bye, boys and girls.
Bye-bye.
When is the right time to take on your giant? Well, Pastor Joey would say, don't wait, don't delay, today is the day. That's right, the right time to trust God and to take on your giant is today, right now. If you choose to ignore it or wait until you're older, then the giant may grow stronger and may create even more problems for you. David didn't wait, and you shouldn't wait either. You may just be a kid, but you are just a kid with amazing God on your side. Boys and girls, can I take a moment to pray with you right now? Would you close your eyes and bow your head? My Heavenly Father, I believe there are boys and girls that have heard my word today, your word that's come from your example of young David, and they're ready to take on that giant problem in their life. Maybe it's anger. Maybe it's an attitude problem. Maybe it's lying. Maybe it's just a bad, nasty habit that they know doesn't please you. It's that giant problem in their life, and they're ready to get rid of it with your help. Father, I pray that right now you would encourage them that they're never too young to take it on right now. Lord, by getting on their hands and knees and asking you to set them free from that giant problem, that you have the power and the authority to take control of that habit, to take control of that lying tongue, to take control of that gossip, whatever it may be, Lord, and get rid of it out of their life so that they can live a life that's pleasing and glorifying to you. Lord, we pray this, we believe this, we walk in this, we stand in this, in your precious and mighty name. And everyone said a big amen. I love you guys. Continue to take on those giants.
Hey, boys and girls, what an incredible message by Pastor Joey. Just a reminder, today's Get to Know is I'm not too young to take on the giants. We loved hanging out with you, and we cannot wait to see you again. See you soon.
No matter what, it's his love that changes everything.